This is Lou Dobbs Tonight. News, debate, and opinion for Monday, April 23rd. Live from New York, Lou Dobbs.
Good evening, everybody. President Bush today blasted Democrats for demanding the resignation of Attorney General Alberto Gonzalez and for recommending troop withdrawals from Iraq. President Bush declared he has even more confidence in Alberto Gonzalez than a week ago. And President Bush said politicians in Washington shouldn't tell generals how to do their jobs. Senate Majority Leader Senator Harry Reid today accused the president of being in a state of denial over Iraq. Senator Reid said the Congress will show President Bush the way forward on Iraq. Ed Henry reports on the president's political offensive against the Democratic leadership. Dana Bash reports on the senator's determination to force the president to withdraw combat troops. And Jamie McIntyre reports from the Pentagon tonight on another major strategic challenge, Russia's opposition to any U.S. missile defenses in Europe. We turn first to Ed Henry. Ed?
Lou, you mentioned that Senator Reid called the president and said, basically in this speech, called him out and said that he's in a state of denial. Just in the last 10 minutes, the White House has put out this two-page attack sheet, basically headlined Reid versus Reid, a state of confusion, ripping his speech to shreds. It's a sign of a White House that is digging in deeper and deeper, not just on Iraq, but also on Alberto Gonzalez.
The president said he gained more confidence in his attorney general after testimony in which Alberto Gonzalez used some variation of,
I do not recall,
64 times.
The attorney general went up and gave a very candid assessment in a way that increased my confidence in his ability to do the job.
The president came to that conclusion despite traveling in Ohio during Gonzalez's testimony.
Did the president actually see the testimony?
He got regular updates from us while we were on the road.
But after sitting through the testimony, Republican Arlen Specter said it was very, very damaging to Gonzalez's credibility.
Some senators didn't like his explanation, but he answered as honestly as he could.
The president was similarly unmoved by increased senatorial pressure on Iraq, digging in deeper on his surge policy.
There's been some progress. There's been some horrific bombings, of course. But there's also a decline in sectarian violence.
In the Oval Office with General David Petraeus, Mr. Bush ducked a question on Majority Leader Harry Reid's charge that he's in denial about the war.
I believe strongly that politicians in Washington shouldn't be telling generals how to do their job. And I believe artificial timetables of withdrawal would be a mistake.
While the president stuck to that familiar refrain, spokeswoman Dana Perino fired back at the senator.
He's also in denial that a surrender date he thinks is a good idea. It is not a good idea. It is defeat. It is a death sentence for the millions of Iraqis who voted for a constitution.
Now, Dana Perino was also asked whether or not the president's personal friendship with Alberto Gonzalez will cloud his judgment here, will prevent him from taking an objective look at the situation. She insisted it will not, but Democrats tonight certainly charging that the president has dug in too deep here. And just as they charged with Donald Rumsfeld that the president stuck with him too long, they think he's doing the same with the attorney general. Lou?
Ed, thank you very much. Ed Henry from the White House. Senate Majority Leader Reid, as Ed just reported, declared the president is in a state of denial over Iraq. Senator Reid said Congress will defy the president's veto threat and pass legislation calling for the withdrawal of all our combat troops from Iraq by April of next year. Dana Bash reports from Capitol Hill.